The Salford Way app is an application for people living with dementia, and it's about supporting them. So it's about really getting the wider community engaged in supporting people who have dementia. So what we did is, along with the Dementia Action Alliance, which is an umbrella group of organisations that support individuals living with dementia, we came together and we saw a gap. There were no businesses engaged in the Dementia Action Alliance, so we thought, how could we get them involved? Went away, had a think, and thought about what's a two-way sort of communication, and we came up with the app. Our business as Salford Community Voluntary Services is literally about getting people to communicate, getting people to support each other, and so on. And so along those lines, we thought about how can we do that, and the app came to mind. And as a tool, we were using that to have businesses support people, but also have businesses become more dementia friendly. So what that entails is that we go in, invite businesses to come onto the app, and then support them to become dementia friends. So they take a dementia friends session, their staff members, so that they have a better understanding about people who may walk through their doors, who may be living with dementia and may need support when they come through the doors. That's really where it sprung from. We'll look at their environment, look at their customer service, and all sorts of things, to be honest, about how we can just support them really as a business to contribute to the fact that Salford as a city is trying to make Salford a better place for everybody. But in this case, it just happens to be people with living with dementia. So therefore, it's getting everybody involved as best as possible, really. How do we evaluate it? On the app, there's a feedback opportunity for people to leave feedback. So when people give their feedback, good or bad, obviously we're concerned when the feedback isn't great. And that's the way we kind of really go in and suggest to a business, well, look, XYZ, a number of people have commented on this. Is there anything that you'd like to have support around trying to improve this kind of situation, basically? There has been occasions where, you know, there people have found that the service of particular services are not good at all, so therefore we've gone in and, you know, suggested how we could improve it together, and the businesses haven't been forthcoming, so therefore we've taken them off the app. So that's really how we kind of monitor. Planning to develop the app by putting a calendar on there. So for people living with dementia, they like to have regularity in their lives. So there are lots of different activities that take place across the city, and we're hoping to put those events on a calendar and have reminders on there so people can know exactly what's going on across the city that is dementia friendly by way of different types of events that they generally go to. So that's one of the features. The other feature is we're looking at developing a sort of almost like a GPS system. So if somebody was to get lost, they could press a button and then we could find them, basically. So we're putting something like that on the app. Normal GPS services are like tracking devices. We're trying not necessarily to track them, but for them to recognize that they may be lost and give out that signal, that distress signal. So that's what we're trying to do. I was with a group of people today who are living with dementia, and they were talking exactly about that. The fact that it gives them a lot of confidence in the services where people have been had the Dementia Friends sessions. So they're more comfortable and more confident in using those services. Must admit, what they did say is that there aren't enough services on, so we're going to try our best to, and improve the number of services. In saying that, the app's, 18 months old, and we've got over 237 services on there, and there are about over 500 people that use the app on a daily basis. That's people living with dementia, carers, and their friends.
I think what I'd like to get across is that even with a diagnosis of dementia, that isn't the end of the journey. Okay, so I was depressed for 2 months when I got my diagnosis, but I came round to thinking, well, I've got an opportunity here to make a difference. be it for me, my friends and future generations. So at the moment I go into schools and I take a toy called Mr. Alzheimer's with me, and the children are gradually getting to understand a bit more about dementia, so they're not fearful, or hopefully a few years along the line they won't be taking the mickey as I've experienced people taking the mickey out of me. It's just educating the next generation, and that's what I'm passionate about. Well, I had several bad experiences in supermarkets, in shops, in car parks, where people would be rude. That's the only word I can find to describe it. People were saying, oh, you can't possibly have dementia, you're too young, you know, you don't look like you've got dementia. Now, what someone with dementia looks like, I really don't know. But that set my mind on thinking, we need a group for younger people. And when I say younger people, I mean people under the age of 65. And we weren't sure if there were many in Salford, so we set up a room in the library in Eccles. And we managed to, we had three people attend the first meeting. And now, 4 years later, we've got about 30 members. So it was just a matter of seeing a need and working out what we could do to meet that need. I think it was, for me, a passion after my diagnosis, because I was diagnosed at 55, and there was nothing in Salford for younger people living with dementia. So after 2 months of being very, very depressed, I decided that we needed to change things. We needed to have something that was age appropriate in the whole area of Salford and Greater Manchester.
People with living with dementia often have experienced difficulties in public, in shops, banks, and offices. And by companies getting involved with the Salford Way, they receive information about people living with dementia, so it helps them to understand if someone who is living with Alzheimer's or another form of dementia comes into their premises, helps them to understand that they might be hesitant, confused, maybe a bit slow. And if you understand that, then you can help that person. Now, by going on the Salford Way app, it's a way of advertising for these companies, but it also ensures people who use the app that anyone who is there has received this basic training in dementia, so that they can, someone living with dementia or their carer, a member of the family, knows that if they go into that building, they will receive compassionate, helpful care, and they won't be rushed, and the atmosphere will be quite pleasant. No massive loud music, no bangs from machinery, things of that nature. It's a much more understanding thing. Well, the Dementia Friends information sessions consist of basically people, an interactive session from lasts about 45, 50 minutes. And it's basic information about how some furnishings can be difficult for someone living with dementia, like a black mat inside a building could look like a black hole to someone who has perceptual problems with dementia. And we help to show them how to have their furniture more space, so you don't have to squeeze past chairs to get somewhere, but also more understanding, more patience, and various things like that, of that nature.
We just seem to be getting more and more people coming in that are friendly, more people are willing to chat with each other, and if more people come in that are living with the same things, it builds a community where they're all working together. We had an evening here where we did various written exercises and spoken exercises, really ways to make you realise that everyone thinks differently, even if they're not living with dementia. We were still getting very different results for the people, and that was an eye-opener, you know, because you automatically assume everyone's the same as you, and they're not. Everyone's just different. Really, I just realised just to approach people with an open mind and just not pressure them. Let them make the decision, let them take the time, let them decide when they're ready, let them look at what they want to buy, and if it's taking them too long or whatever, just let them do it. And not get stressed about it, and not be rude to them, just be trying to be helpful. It lets people know where they can go, where it's safe, where people understand them. And if everyone uses that and goes to those places, then they'll see familiar faces, and then they feel at home.